He stopped. Thank you very much, Andy Grammer. Fine by me. Right, it's time for this week's Tune with a Tale. Your chance to share with us a song in your life that has a story to tell. Last week, while discussing what to wear at a relative's wedding, Ace Baker, Pat Kellaway, chose the Barry Manilow classic Copacabana. Who's getting the coasters today? His name is Martin Cheek. Good afternoon, Martin.
Hi, Graham. How are you?
I'm very well, thanks for asking. And where do I find you, Martin?
I live in Broadstairs on the Kent coast by the seaside.
Love. Broadstairs is such a pretty town.
Yeah, it is. It's very Victorian still. It's like going back in time sometimes.
And now, did somebody open a new art gallery there or something?
That's Margate. That's the Turner Centre in Margate, which is our adjacent town. We're between Margate and Ramsgate. They're both about 3 miles away.
Is there much rivalry between the three?
Well, we think we're the best, of course, but Margate's really on the up, and they're putting a lot of money into it. They've just got a load of money to restore the high street. Good luck with that one. I'm not sure yeah, whether I'd put
that's
my
quite,
money into
that's
that.
Quite,
but never mind.
It is quite depressing that you've got to restore a high street. It really should be kind of self-restoring.
Well, it should be, but we've got Westwood Cross now, which is a sort of one of these multiplexes, so everybody goes there, and that's why a lot of the high streets, I think not just Margate, but a lot of places are suffering, you know.
And is Broadstairs, is that the place that has Bleak House in it?
Yeah, Bleak House is next door to me, and it was Dickens' house, and he did write David Copperfield there.
Wow.
And Archway House is attached to our house, and he wrote, some of Barnaby Rudge there.
Oh, right. And was Bleak House for sale?
It was recently, yes. And I think the person who bought it, they've restored it, and they're thinking about selling it again, I think.
Oh,
but it's, dare I say, it's a pretty ugly building with these horrible castellations and things. It's not a beautiful thing.
Good luck selling it now. Thanks for that, Martin. Yeah.
I wouldn't
what
want
a great
to
neighbour
like
you turned out to be.
Our house was built in 1720 when the shipwrights joined forces.
Wow. Is it a real headache to maintain?
Well, it is, and it's right on the sea, so if I showed you a wall and said, when do you think I last painted that, you'd think 20 years ago, but in fact it's painted last year. It's like having a boat. You've got to keep painting it and scraping it down and painting it again.
And
I love it.
Who do you share your very old house with?
Well, my family. I've got a wife, Margaret, who's a portrait painter, and Thomas is 22. He's just graduated in architecture. And my daughter Molly is 17. She's doing her exams. We're all very arty in our family, Graham.
It's 'cause, are you a mosaic artist?
I am, yeah. I absolutely love it. It sounds a bit like Johnny No Mate sitting making mosaics all the time, but in fact it's really good. I get to travel all over the world. Because I've written books, people know me in Australia and America and New Zealand and so on. In fact, I'm more popular. The further I go, the more popular I am.
In mosaic circles.
That's right. So,
and what do you make your mosaics out of? What are you breaking
up? America, of course, because there's a lot of them. Even though it's a minority thing, there's enough of them to, for me, I tour every year all around America and have a great time, yeah.
Sorry, I missed, what do you make the mosaic out of?
Well, I'm a bit different because I make my own glass pieces. I've got a glass fusion kiln, and I cut the glass and make them myself. So most people would imagine that it's a bit like Roman mosaics, but in fact it's not. I mean, my work is more inspired by Disney's Thumper from Bambi than it is from any Roman mosaic, really.
Because you did work in animation, didn't you?
I did, yeah. I used to animate Paddington Bear, and we always thought we could do what the computers couldn't, and that they'd it would always be better, because I was a 3D animator.
Yeah.
And then John Lasseter, who we always knew was the best, he brought out Toy Story, and we lost the argument, basically.
Because that is extraordinary, that film.
Yeah, it was fantastic. I mean, I could have become a computer animator, but I didn't want to spend the rest of my life staring at a computer screen. I liked the actual physical thing of making and manipulating the puppets, so funnily, making mosaics mentally, the way you apply yourself with this one tessera at a time or one frame at a time in animation, mentally it's almost identical, actually.
Now, I'm also very excited that you're on, because you can now explain what the song you've chosen is about. I have never known. I have just read the lyrics. I still don't know. So
well,
tell us what you've chosen and what the story is.
A lot of people are mystified by this. The song is The Human by The Killers, and the key is that Hunter S. Thompson, the writer who wrote Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas and wrote for the Rolling Stone magazine, he said that America was turning into a country of dancers. And he said, actually, he said America is raising a generation of dancers. In other words, I think he meant a generation of sort of puppets who do everything in unison without thinking independently. And so the song is actually a very liberating idea, which is to say, cut the cord. In other words, if you're a puppet, cut the cord and start being yourself and doing your own thing.
Well, I've learned something today.
It reminds me a lot of Pinocchio, actually, when he sings, I've got no strings to hold me down to make me fret or make me frown. And then he says, how I love my liberty, there are no strings on me. And I think that's probably the best explanation for the song, actually.
Well, with that in mind, we'll hear it now. Very nice to talk to you, Martin.
Thanks, Graham. Bye.
All right, cheers now. Bye. Today's Tune with the Tale.
I did my best to notice when the call came down the line. Up to the platform of surrender, I was brought, but I was kind. And sometimes I get nervous when I see an open door. Close your eyes, clear your heart. Cut the cord. Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold. And I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human? Or are
That was today's Tube of the Tale, as chosen by Martin Cheek. What a very intelligent, informative man he was. And how sorry that we're going to ruin his beautiful home by sending our coasters to it. Still, when they fall apart, he can incorporate them into mosaic. We've plenty left, by the way, so if you would like 4 wipe-free Tube of the Tale coasters, just share a song in your life that has a story to tell. Email graham.norton@bbc.co.uk. As long as it's clean, it could be a future Tube of the Tale. And if you make it on air, you will get your coasters. For more details, visit my show page at bbc.co.uk/radio2 and click on Take Part in the Show.